Sitting next to me is one of the speakers at CI 2016, Amy Ng. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
Now, you'll be speaking about rehabilitation in adults with CIs.
Yes, and we work with adults at Sunnybrook, mm-hmm. and many of them are late deafened, and they, you know, maybe had decades without hearing, and once they get a cochlear implant, they need a little training to make use of the new sounds.
So what are some of the things that you tell them when they...
Well, I think the most important thing for them to realize is that when they get more sounds than they've had with their hearing aid, there's a time that they have to adapt to it, and they have to, it's almost like a leap of faith. You will get used to it. It sounds different. There's more information. There's a little lag time between when your brain starts using all that information, but you will be able to do it. And I think for a lot of our adults, just having some support and some guidance in what to do to help themselves get there faster is a big relief for them.
I imagine it's somewhat of an emotional journey as well.
Well, one of my favorite things about working with cochlear implant patients is that you really develop a long-term relationship with them. You know, for the pediatrics, the audiologists watch their children grow up, and I watch my patients grow old, and we grow old together, so I know about their families and their kids, and that's one of my favorite things about being a part of the cochlear implant program is the relationship, long-term relationship you develop with your patients.
So what about following rehabilitation, even in experienced CI users? Do they go back to the specialist for sort of tune-ups?
For an adult, their follow-up follows a pattern based on their hearing history. So they come to see me at Sunnybrook at the one-month mark, and I assess them. I see what they're able to pick up, what they're able to understand, and what type of exercises can bring them to the next level of comprehension.
How important is rehabilitation to the success of a CI?
I think rehabilitation is very important, and it's critical for the success of a CI because we're training the brain. The ear is not just out there attached to nothing. It's attached to a brain. And the brain is sort of like the computer. It has to receive the input of the cochlear implant, but it has to make sense of it. To improve that is something that helps that learning curve increase, and you get to your potential faster. And I think for adults, that part sometimes isn't always available for an adult. For pediatrics, they're always trying to have a goal where they learn language. So it's very crystal clear what the rehabilitation for a child is. For an adult, sometimes the goals are very different. Sometimes they, want to be able to use the telephone. They want to be able to experience music again. They want to be able to hear their grandchildren. You know, those goals are, because some of them, quite frankly, know five languages already. So those things are accomplished. The goals have to be, a part of the rehabilitation of an adult.
If you're speaking with someone who is considering a cochlear implant, what is the one piece of advice that you would share with them?
I would have to say that be ready to experience a lot of different sounds that you maybe perhaps didn't realize existed. And just be patient with yourself and be ready to work and look for meaning in the sounds that you do hear. Because the brain is the most comprehensive and amazing part of the whole deal. And it is flexible. It is plastic. You can teach it. And we have people who maybe lost the high pitches many years ago when they were working in construction, perhaps. And then, you know, over the years, they went deaf and they haven't heard the high pitches for maybe 20, 30 years, and then you get them a cochlear implant. Sometimes especially the high pitches can be very overwhelming because the brain doesn't just stay plastic waiting for the next sound to come that doesn't come for decades. It uses that brain power for something else, for vision, for feeling, for lip reading, all sorts of things. So once you get the sound in, you also have to start getting the sounds processed in new real estate that in the brain that might have been taken over by other functions.
Fascinating. Well, thank you so much for joining us, and best of luck with your speech and the rest of CI 2016.
Thank you. So much.
Thank you.